Hello friends, welcome back. I am Neha Pariyani. Today we will discuss about joint stock company. So let's begin. Joint stock company. Let's try to understand what is a joint stock company in detail. A company can be described as an artificial person having a separate legal entity, perpetual succession and a common seal. Okay, so basically there are four aspects in this definition. Okay, first is a company is an artificial person. So according to law, this type of company is treated as an artificial person. Okay, so because the registration of this type of companies is compulsory, they are treated as artificial person because they have their own name, own brand, own goodwill, reputation, etc. Right, so in the eyes of law, the joint stock company is treated as artificial person. Having a separate legal entity. So it says that it has a separate legal entity. That is, it is not dependent upon the owners. Okay, owners and this joint stock company are treated as two different entities. Okay, this company has its own existence. Hence, it has a separate legal entity. Right, the third aspect is perpetual succession. So this term means that joint stock company is a creation of law and it can only be liquidated by the act of law. Okay, so death, insanity, lunacy of its owner will not affect the continuity of the business. So because it is creation of law, it has to be liquidated by the act of law. Hence, it has a perpetual succession. Right, the fourth and last aspect is common seal. So because it is treated as artificial person and it is separate from its owners, it has a common seal. You can also call it a stamp. So there has to be a common seal on all the necessary documents of this type of companies. Okay. Next, joint stock companies are governed by the Companies Act 1956. Okay, so they are governed by the provisions of Companies Act 1956. But now this act has been updated. Now it has changed to Companies Act 2013. Okay, so many rules and regulations have also been changed and many amendments have also been made in this act. Right? Next, capital is contributed in the form of shares and are easily transferable. So in this type of organization, the capital is contributed by the issue of shares. So these shares are the monetary instruments which are used to pool the capital from its members. Alright, so the members who are interested to be the member of this type of company can purchase the shares and become the member or owners of this type of company. Remember, the person who purchases certain shares will directly become the owners of joint stock company. Okay, and they are easily transferable. If any person loses interest or don't want to continue as the owner, they can easily transfer their shares to any other persons. Right, next, owned by shareholders but managed by board of directors. Okay, so the persons who purchases the shares are known as shareholders, right? Shareholders are the owners of joint stock company, but it is managed by board of directors. So these are the persons who are appointed as representatives. Okay, so these board of directors are appointed by shareholders in order to manage all the business activities. Alright, so this was about the concept of joint stock company. Now let's discuss the features of a joint stock company. They are, first is artificial person. So as I said earlier, because of the registration is compulsory, this type of organization is treated as an artificial person in the eyes of law. Alright, next, separate legal entity. It is separate from its owner. It has its own separate legal existence and also a common stamp or common seal, right? Next, formation. When compared to any other forms of business organization, its formation is little complex and registration of this type of company is compulsory. Alright, next, it is governed by the provisions of Companies Act 1956, okay? Remember, only after certificate of registration being issued by the registrar of the company. Only after that, this type of company can start its business activities. Alright, next, it has perpetual succession. So, as I said earlier, this type of company is creation of law and can be liquidated only by the act of law. Alright, so death, insolvency, lunacy or incapabilities of any of its owner will not affect the continuity of the business. Even if all its owners dies, this type of business will continue to exist with new owners. Right, next, control. Control and management of business activities lies in the hands of board of directors. Okay, so they are the representatives who are appointed by the shareholders in order to carry on the business activities. Alright, even though shareholders are the owners of the organization, they cannot be involved in the day-to-day activities of the business. Hence, the control lies in the hands of board of directors. Right, next, liability. So the liability of shareholders is limited in this type of organization. Liability of every owner is limited. Okay, next, risk bearing. Risk bearing is between all the shareholders according to their capital investment ratio. Okay, so the risk is collectively bared by all the partners. Next, common seal. So while discussing the definition, we came to know that joint stock company has its common seal and it has to be compulsorily mentioned on each and every necessary documents of the company, right? So these were about the features of a joint stock company. Next, let's discuss the merits of joint stock company. They are, first is limited liability. So as I said earlier, each and every owner has limited liability, right? So if the losses occur in the organization, it will affect only to the extent of capital contributed, right? Next, transfer of interest. So the person who does not want to continue as owner or who loses the interest from the organization can easily transfer their shares to others. Hence, it is also a merit. Perpetual existence. So it has perpetual succession, right? It can only be liquidated by the act of law. Any death, lunacy, insolvency of owners will not be affected. Hence, there is a continuity of this type of business. Next, scope of expansion. This type of organization has a lot of scope for expansion. Okay, so there is no deficiency of capital in this type of organization because it can invite general public to invest in its organization. Hence, there is a large scope or greater scope for expansion in this type of organization. Next, professional management. So as I said, there is no deficiency in the capital. They can appoint the professional management or experts in the management field to manage the activities of the business. Alright, so these were the merits of the joint stock company. At last, we have demerits of joint stock company. They are complexity in formation. So when compared to other types of organization, formation of a joint stock company is complex. Alright, so many legal formalities are needed to be followed for formation of a joint stock company. Okay, next, lack of secrecy. So a joint stock company has to maintain several accounts or records of its transaction and it also has to show it to general public in order to invite it to invest their capital. Alright, so hence there is no secrecy in this type of organization. Numerous regulations. So we know that this type of organizations are governed by the provisions of Companies Act, right? So it has to follow lots and lots of regulations, rules and regulations that comes under Companies Act 1956 or now it is Companies Act 2013. Alright, next, impersonal work environment. So we know that in this type of organization, the owners are different and the managers are different, right? So board of directors and shareholders are different. Hence, there is no personal contact between them. And due to the large size of the business, it makes it difficult for them to maintain the personal contact between shareholders and board of directors, that is owners and management, right? Hence, there is impersonal work environment. Okay, delay in decision making. So there are lots and lots of members who are involved in decision making process. So because there are many members, the decision cannot be easily taken, right? So point of view or opinion of each and every person will not be same. Hence there is delay in decision making. Next is oligarchic management. There is oligarchic management in this type of organization. So it means that the board of directors manage all the business activities, right? So the shareholders of the companies are spread over all over the country, right? So they cannot attend the board meetings as well. So the whole power is in the hands of board of directors, right? So the disinterested shareholders will transfer their shares to other persons, right? Because of this oligarchic management. So this is the demerit. All right. Next, conflict in interests. So there are differences in interest among different types of members in the company. For example, shareholders wants higher rate of dividends, right? So employees wants higher salaries. So there is differences in the interest in this type of organization. Hence there is conflicts between them. Alright, so these were certain demerits of joint stock company. So this was all about today. If you found this helpful, please hit the like button. Also subscribe to my channel. For any questions and queries, you can ask me in the comment section below. Hope to see you in my next videos. Till that, happy learning.